رضيت بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, truly the best speech and the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وكل ضلالة في النار. Every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثم أما بعد. My dear brothers in Islam, we are continuing to review حق المسلم على المسلم أو حقوق المسلم على المسلم, the rights of the Muslim upon their other Muslim brothers and sisters in faith in Islam. And we have reached this point where we get to one of the rights being that you should not afflict your brother or sister in Islam with anything harmful or disliked, because Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Kullu al-Muslim 'ala al-Muslim haram, damuhu wa maluhu wa 'irdahu." Rawahu Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Every Muslim is inviolable to any other Muslim. That is true for his life, his wealth, and his honor." So the life, the wealth, the honor, especially for the one who is your brother or sister in faith, is held to a higher degree, and you should not break or dishonor that. ثُمَّ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ لَا يَحِلُّ لِمُسْلِمٍ أَنْ يُرَوَّعَ مُسْلِمًا. رواه أبو داود وصححه الألباني. And Shaykh al-Albani, he authenticated the hadith where the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, it is not allowed for a Muslim to scare or inflict terror or fright into another Muslim. Nowadays, we see amongst those who are brothers and sisters in families and in faith, on top of it, fighting, arguing, insulting one another, threatening one another, and at worst times, even killing one another. And this is not a thing you just hear of once in a while now, it's become common. You're not even supposed to scare or cause fright or worry in your brother or sister in faith. ثُمَّ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ الْمُسْلِمُ مَنْ سَلَمَ الْمُسْلِمُونَ مِنْ لِسَانِهِ وَيَدِهِ. رواه البخاري ومسلم. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, the Muslim is the one from whose tongue and hand the other Muslims are safe. Safe from your tongue, that you don't lie to them, that you don't backbite them, that you don't slander them, that you do not give false oaths to them, that you not spread tales about them, that you not insult them. This is being safe from the tongue of the other Muslim. But yet, amongst Muslim to Muslim, this is all things that many of us, the brothers and the sisters, are rampant in doing. Safe from the hand of another Muslim, from their abuse, from their hitting, any action that would bring them harm, from stealing. And again, we warn of the stealing of the mirath, of the inheritance that is done between the family members. Commonly, it is the brothers stealing from the sisters who have a share in the mirath, the inheritance of those who have left something to them. And finally, we have the hadith المؤمن من أمنه المؤمنون على أنفسهم وأموالهم. رواه أحمد وإسناده صحيح. And the Prophet ﷺ said, the believer is the one from whom believers' lives and wealth are secure. We have to own up to these rights, that the life, the wealth, the honor of our brothers and sisters and faith are something we have to maintain and hold with a high degree. Clearly, a matter that we see that is a right of a Muslim on another Muslim is that you should be humble towards your brother in Islam and never be arrogant towards him. And you should not even get to the point where you even make him or her stand up from their place in order for you to take that seat. And this is a common thing in our cultures, out of respect, that you'll get up and give your chair to someone else. And we're going to see that this is against the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Allah, he said, وَلَا تُسَعِّرْ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرْحَى إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ مُخْتَالٍ فَخُورٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, what means, and turn not your face away from men with pride or arrogance, nor walk in insolence through the earth. Verily Allah likes not each arrogant boaster. Allah hates this arrogance. This is your way towards your family. You should be one who has no arrogance towards your family, towards your neighbors, towards you know, but even to your brother and sister in faith, the Muslim brother and sister in faith, to a higher degree, you should be humble with them. Our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَنْ كَانَ فِي قَلْبِهِ ذَرًّا مِّنْ كِبْرٍ لَمْ يُرِحْ رَائِحَةَ الْجَنَّةِ. The one who has an atom's weight. An atom, you're seeing it flying around, but you can't even see it. This is how light it is. Whoever has that little amount of arrogance in their heart, they will not smell from the fragrances of Jannah, of paradise. Our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ أَوْحَى إِلَيَّ أَن تَوَاضَعُوا حَتَّى لَا يَفْخَرَ أَحَدٌ عَلَىٰ أَحَدٍ. رواه مسلم. And our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Allah revealed to me that people should be humble with one another to the point that none boasts over another. Again, this is a disease we see amongst the brothers and sisters. Everything's a competition. Everything is about who I can show up more. Everything is about walking mightier with your chest out, your head up, as if you're better than other people. Maybe because of the money you have. Maybe because of the degree you got. Maybe it's from the family you're from or the country you're from. And none of this to Allah means anything if you do not have taqwa. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَا تَوَادَعَ أَحَدٌ لِلَّهِ إِلَّا رَفَعُهُ اللَّهِ. رواه مسلم. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, no one is humble for the sake of Allah. No one is humble and rids the pride and arrogance from their heart and their actions for the sake of Allah, except that Allah will raise him in status and virtue. The one who will give you Jannah, potentially, or send you to the hellfire, potentially. The one who can raise you in status in Jannah, because you humbled yourself in this earth. You didn't walk proudly, and you didn't treat others with arrogance. Always remember, my brothers in Islam, that this earth that we see, that we plant in, this is the earth that Allah created us from. مِنْهَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ وَفِيهَا نُعِيدُكُمْ وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُكُمْ طَارَةً أُخْرَى. The earth, Allah, He created us from it, and then He returned us to it upon our death, and then He will resurrect us from that same dirt. Why are you arrogant and proud? What do you have better than others? You're made from the same dirt of the earth that Allah made every one of us. So the only one, it's like it says above this masjid door, that part of that ayah in Surah Al-Hujurat, إِنَّ أَكْرَمُكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. The one with the most honor in the sight of Allah, in the sight of Allah, is the one who has the most taqwa, the one who keeps their duty to Allah and fears Allah most. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, لَا يُقِيمَنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ رَجُلًا مِّن مَجْلِسِهِ ثُمَّ يَجْلِسُ فِيهِ وَلَكِنْ تَوَسَّعُوا وَتَفَسَّحُوا. رواه البخاري ومسلم. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, to the point we alluded to, none of you should make a man stand up from his place of sitting and then take his seat. Instead, you should spread out and make room for everyone to sit. So even this thing that we have made a thing of honor in the cultures of some of our lands, is a thing that opposes the sunnah of Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Look at the humbleness that the Muslims gave to one another. Umar radiallahu anhu, he was committed to a blind old woman's house to go and take her water and to manage her affairs and to clean her home. And then one day he went and he saw that someone had beat him to it. Again, he saw someone had beaten him to it. So he hid out so he could see who was this man who was taking this ajr away from him. And it was Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. When he was the Khalifa, go give me one person in the land who has the title president or mayor or manager or whatever, who will go and do these things. This was the humility and the humbleness of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum wa radahum. He would go when he was the Khalifa, clean an old blind lady's home, bring her water, make her food, take care of all of her affairs. Umar radiallahu anhu, it was said when he went to Bayt al-Maqdis, to al-Quds, to Jerusalem, when they had conquered it in his time when he was the Khalifa, it was said that when he entered it, he was taking turns the whole journey on his camel with one of his companions. And the turn when they were entering was when Umar radiallahu anhu, the Khalifa, was walking the camel and his companion was on it. Nowadays, limos, big vans, nice cars, the nicest of things, hundreds of thousands of dollars of vehicles to transport people who are important. Wal'ayadu billah. This is not the humility nor the humbleness of the Muslim. Countless stories we have from the Prophet ﷺ and his companions of hunger, of thirst, of torn clothing, of charity that they gave away all of what they had just to give it in the way of Allah. That we have for us to reflect upon so that we're humble and have humility. This is a haqq towards all of humanity, to even the animal. But it's a especially higher degree of rights to your brother and sister in Islam. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ادعوا الله يغفر لكم ذنوبكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. My dear brothers in Islam, again, many people in our lives have rights over us. Our spouses, our children, our parents, our neighbors, all of humanity has some type of right over us. Even the animal has a right that you treat it well and you don't make it suffer when you sacrifice it for eating. But as brothers and sisters in faith, we have a degree of rights over one another that's unfounded anywhere else, just because we all bear witness, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Just because we testify together that there is no one worthy of worship except for Allah alone without partners, and that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is his messenger and his slave servant. We need to fulfill these rights. We've done 3 weeks and we will continue to even do maybe at least another two or three just on this topic. So this isn't something small in the sight of Allah. And our Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم spent a lot of effort to teach us it. To conclude one for today, is that a right of a Muslim on another Muslim is that the Muslim should not boycott another Muslim for more than 3 days. Based on the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا يحل لمسلم أن يهجر أخاه فوق ثلاث يلتقيان فيعرض هذا ويعرض هذا وخيرهما الذي يبدأ بالسلام. رواه بخاري ومسلم. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, it's not allowed for a Muslim to boycott another Muslim. It's not allowed for a Muslim to boycott. This is the boycotting where you say, I'm not going to go to this place if that brother is there. That's boycotting. It's not just when you see him, you don't give him salam. If you're not going to the masjid because you know someone's praying there, if you're not going to give someone a condolence because you know someone's going to be there, this is boycotting that person who you're trying to avoid. It is not allowed for the Muslim to boycott his brother for more than 3 days. You get 72 hours to work it out in your head, in your heart, to figure out why you're so upset, to figure out how you're going to put this past you. And then it becomes a sin if you continue in that state. You get 3 days if it's really that worth it. And when they meet each other, each one turns away from the other, avoiding them. Brothers in faith, our first haqq al-Muslim ala Muslim was what? Was the tafshiyat al-salam. To give the salam to one another, to those you know, those you don't know. Right? It's not allowed to boycott your brother for more than 3 days. When they meet each other, they just turn away from each other. The best of them is the one who begins with the greeting of the salam. So greet with the salam. It'll ease tensions. It'll increase the hub, the love between one another. And maybe break that hardship. At the very minimum, you do it. If he won't respond, the malaika will say, wa alaykum as-salam to you. And what better greeting of response than from them? So greet one another and do not avoid one another. ثم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تدابروا وكونوا عباد الله إخوانا رواه مسلم. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, do not avoid one another, but be brethren, servants of Allah. Avoiding is a type of backbiting. Not going to a place because someone is there is a type of avoidance. It's a type of boycotting. And it is what's referenced here. You got 3 days when this stupidity enters your heart and in your mind to work it out, figure it out, and get it past it. Or else you are sinning and disobeying Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah make us from those who honor the rights of one another. Allahumma ighfir lil muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka anta sami'un qareebun mujibud da'wat ya muqallib al qulub thabbit quluban ala deenik. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك سبحان ربك رب العزة أما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.